At the end of our session, we will create this kind of program. I make it smaller, function, summation, a, b, var, s equals 0, for I equal a, I less than b, plus plus I, s plus equal I, return s. Function, product, a, b, let s equal 1, while a is not equal b, s times a plus plus, return s. We will implement syntax highlighting feature in this episode. Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is August 30th, 2020. This is my 37th episode about vector calculus and classical electromagnetism. Also, this is the second episode about plot graph. In this episode, we will learn how to implement syntax highlighter using QSyntax highlighter. To follow my current session, I assume you have watched my previous episode, episode 36, because my current session continues from my previous video, plot graph 1. If you haven't watched this video, please double-click this link and watch this video. Otherwise, you may not be able to follow my current session. I also assume you have watched episode 20, Python code in Qt Widget C++ application 1. If you haven't watched this video, you may not be able to follow my current session. From my previous episode, scroll down, show more. In the download source code section, please double click this link to download source code from our previous episode. Show in folder, extract, then rename it 037. Copy the folder, copy, paste it to your working directory. Now start Visual Studio 2019. Go to File, Open, Project Solution. In your working directory, 037 plot graph, plot app, select the solution, click Open. Expand the solution, Ctrl F5. This is the state of our previous episode. Now close it. Right-click the project, add Qt class, select Qt class, code, editor, click add, click next. Base class should be Q text edit. Constructor signature should be QWidget. Click Finish. Now save all. Form the file javascript-widget.ui. Select this control. Currently, class name is QTextEdit. Right click, promote class name, code, editor, click add. Select this checkbox, promote. Now save, close it, Ctrl F5. You should be able to build successfully. Now close it. Select class view, expand, select code editor, right click, add a function. Function name will be set font and tab size. Return type will be void. Access public. Click this button. Constant. QString. Font name. Hit enter. Click this button. Int. Tab size. Hit enter. Click OK. Here. Auto font. This font. I say current font. Current font. Set point size 14. Current font. Set family font name. Cube font. Matrix. Matrix. Current font. This set tab stop with tab size times matrix with this set font current font. Sorry, I will change the function parameter int point size. Copy, paste, also here, int, point, size. Now, press Ctrl F5. Now, close it. In Java, script widget, right click, go to definition. In Java, script widget definition, UI text edit JavaScript set font and tab size. Font name will be Courier New. Font size, for example, 16. Tab size 4. Ctrl F5. Now, if we type text, text is much bigger. This is tab size. If you don't like this font, then you can change it. For example, Times New Roman. Ctrl F5. Now it's Times New Roman font. Close it. Select codeeditor.h once again. I forgot ampersand here. Also, code editor CPP ampersand here. Now select Solution Explorer once again. Select the project. Right click. Add Qt class. Select Qt class. It should be syntax highlighter. Click add. Click next. Base class should be Q syntax highlighter. Click finish. For more information about syntax highlighter, please double click this link. In this documentation, Q syntax highlighter, this is the constructor. We have to use Q text document. Copy and syntax highlighter, paste it here. Disable it. Copy here. Class paste. Fix your code like this. Copy once again. Copy syntax highlighter.cpp paste. Delete semicolon, include Q text document. Press Ctrl F5. Double click it. Sorry, we have to delete Q. Also, remove Q. Press Ctrl F5. Now it should work successfully. Now close it. In this documentation, I will copy the link. Copy. I will paste it here for your reference. In this documentation, if you scroll down, you can find this sample code. Copy it in CPP, paste. Copy, paste, copy, paste. It is virtual function. This function is called by the Qt toolkit. Save all, press Ctrl+F5 once again. Double click it. We need to include regular expression. Copy regular expression, Ctrl Home, include paste. We may also need text character format. Include paste, Ctrl+F5. Now it should work successfully. Close it. In syntax highlighter, include qset, include qstring. In the public section, public qset qstring keywords. Now press Ctrl+F5. Now close it. JavaScript widget. We will change the font. Courier. New. Press Ctrl+F5. It should work. Close it. JavaScript widget. This header file. Class. Syntax. Highlighter. Here. Protected. Syntax. Highlighter. Syntax. Highlighter. Copy. In the JavaScript widget.cpp. Paste. This. Equal. New. Syntax. Highlighter. Here. Include syntax highlighter. UI text edit JavaScript document. Syntax highlighter has a member keywords. This keyword is qset of string. We will store JavaScript keyword here. For JavaScript keyword, please double click this link. These are JavaScript keywords. I prepared JavaScript keywords in advance. Copy, paste. Fix your code like this. In the syntax highlighter.cpp, here, we have to remove mine. If keywords contains matchy, copy, paste, capture, 0. Fix your code like this. Now press Ctrl+F5. This is our program. Function summation a b bar s equals 0 for I equals a I less than b plus plus I s plus equal I return s. Our program looks working perfectly, but it's not. Currently, it cannot handle comment block. Also, this is comment block. Comment block cannot handle. So we will fix this problem. Now close it. Close it. In the syntax highlighter dot h, copy this function, copy, protected, faced, handle, comment, block. Return type should be bool. Constant, qstring, ampersand, start expression, constant, qstring, ampersand, end expression. I will put a carriage return here. Fix your code like this. Copy in the syntax highlighter.cpp. Here, faced. Copy the class name. Put it here. Now, in the qsyntax highlighter class documentation in this file, scroll down. For example, if we are writing simple C++ syntax highlighter, this part, copy text up to this point, copy here, faced. Now, start expression, copy, start expression, faced it here, end expression, faced it here. Also, if start index less than 0, return false. Now scroll down here. This is out of while loop. Return true. Fix your code like this. Scroll down. Now here, if this handle comment block, we have to pass text, then quote, forward slash to backward slash star. We open first backward slash star, quote, backward slash star, forward slash, return. We handle comment blocks. If this handle comment block text to forward slash quote end of line dollar symbol return. We handle C++ style comment block. Now press Ctrl F5. This is C style multi-line comment block function int var return function summation AB return A plus B. This is single line comment function product AB product of A and B. Return A times B. Now return result. Our program works perfectly. I will first complete source code to my website. By the time you watch this video, you can double click this link and download complete source code.